Top of the first here at Jefferson, and Marissa Quagula gets Lenape Valley going with this line drive single up the middle for the Pats. Then it's Katie Maiello with the two-strike opposite field ground ball single to left, and the Pats are set up with runners on first and second. And after a perfect Rachel Brenninger sack bunt put runners in scoring position, it's Allie Tafaro with the two-run single to left as it drops in, as Quagula and Maiello score, and Tafaro takes second on the throw, and Lenape Valley has a 2-0 lead. Then with two outs, it's Megan Blomerquain. She starts her big day as she delivers the RBI single to left as Tafaro comes around the score, and the Pats are up 3-0 over the Falcons, still here in the first inning. And Kayla Romano caps the four-run outburst here with his ribby single to left as courtesy runner Sydney Burlow scores, and the Pats have a quick 4-0 lead. We go to the top of the second, and Jefferson pitcher Melissa Yurkevich settles down and puts together a 1-2-3 inning for the Falcons as she gets the K here, but Jefferson still trails 4-0. All right, Jefferson starts the bottom of the second on a good note. Watch freshman sensation Isabel Cease crush this pitch the other way for a leadoff double to left for Jefferson. Then it's Lauren Gutowski with the single for the Falcons, and Jefferson scores here on the error, and then Gutowski advances a third on the throw, but she's left stranded, and it stays 4-1 Lenape Valley. Jefferson goes back to work here in the bottom of the third, and it's Isabel Cease again. Watch her rip this RBI double to left to play Caitlin Doherty, who reached on a walk, and Jefferson makes it a two-run game as Lenape Valley leads 4-2. Okay, top of the fifth, and after Rachel Brenninger and Allie DeFaro singled and moved up on a sack bunt by Bree Simcoe, the Pats score here on the Megan Blomquin grounder to third as the runner beats the throw home, and it's 5-2 Lenape Valley. Then Kayla Romano blasts his two-run ground rule double to left as it gets caught up in the fence, allowing Tafaro and Sydney Burlow to score, and Lenape Valley pushes its lead to 5 runs, 7-2. But Jefferson has an answer with just one swing of the bat. Watch Isabel Cease crush this 3-run dinger to dead center. Jefferson trails 7-5. She finished 3-for-3 with 2 doubles, a home run, and 4 RBIs. She's the real deal, folks. All right, we move to the top of the seventh, and in a great at-bat, watch Bree Simcoe with the leadoff single to center after fouling off numerous pitches to stay alive. Okay, here's the first of 2 wild plays in the inning. Watch Megan Bowman playing with the double to right, and on the Jefferson error, Antoinette Simonetti races home to score, and then the throw goes into dead ball territory, which allows Buonapane to score, and Lenape Valley has a 4-run cushion, 9-5, as we head to the bottom of the seventh. Huge play there. And it's huge because watch Stephanie Agnes come through with the bases loaded RBI single to center for Jefferson, and it's 9-6 as C scores, and the bags are still filled with Falcons. Then watch courtesy runner Claire Bone scoot home on the wild pitch, and all of a sudden we have a 2-run game, 9-7, with runners on second and third, and only 1 out for the Falcons. Okay, watch Nicole Vassallo Jefferson drop down the bunt, but Lenape Valley pitcher Kayla Romano makes the heads-up play, tags the runner, throws the first. Now the Pats have the Jefferson runner in a rundown, and they get her for the final out of the game for an unlikely double play as Lenape Valley escapes with a huge 9-7 Freedom Division victory at Jefferson High School.
It was great. You know, we've always had good games, and every time we play them, it's always good. We always know it's going to be tough, but both of us, we come out as hard as we can. You know, we play our best. It's always a good game, and they're a great team, but we just came out on top this time, and I'm so happy.
It felt great. Like, this is what we needed to do. I mean, we were all in the game. Everyone was part of the victory, and it just felt really good.
We have been prepared for this game since our first practice. So, honestly, just coming out here, it got postponed last time. We were so ready. We were so pumped up, and we're just really happy that we got the win.
I thought you did a great job. You just talked to Kayla. It starts with her on the mound, and she's been pitching great, and she was struggling with her control today because I know she had told you, but she had hurt her hand at work yesterday, and it was just she had ripped the skin right off and couldn't grip the ball, so she was only throwing fastballs and changeups, so she had to move the ball around, try to keep them off balance. You know, both teams did, I thought, a good job hitting the ball, staying back, and it was a exciting game.
Lenape Valley set the tone early, scoring 4 runs in the first inning, getting a big 2-run single from Allie Tafaro, and also an RBI single from Megan Buonapane.
That's big. We've been struggling a little bit scoring some runs, so it was nice to jump out there early and get that lead and be able to have a little bit of a cushion for.
Buonapane did a great job swinging the bat today. She was 2-for-3, 3 runs scored, and a double.
That felt good for me. I've been in a slump a little bit, so I was just ready. I was practicing on Sunday with my coach personally, and I guess it just showed, and it was great.
Speaking of doubles in the fifth inning, Kayla Romano ripped a big two-run double to left to help Lenape Valley pad their lead.
It actually didn't really feel like I hit it, but I mean, those are the best kinds of hits. So I've been in a slump lately, and that was really helpful, a confidence booster for me.
Both teams were really battling today, but Lenape Valley found a way to win.
We're blessed to have Kayla as a pitcher and have Megan behind there calling those pitches every time. Like, I get frustrated, you know, I see them go right down the pike and we don't get it called, but you know, they come back every time. I have to give them so much credit. They every time. I'm never worried with them on there.
Crazy last play of the game, double play on a rundown. Kayla Romano with a heads up play on a bunt, tagging the runner at trying to score, then turning, throwing the first, and then the Lenape Valley Patriots took it over from there.
I knew we needed the two outs. We only had one, and they were close. We only had a few runs on them. But I had the ball. I saw her going home, and I figured I would just tag her. And I turned and saw her going to second, and I just threw it, just instinct. But I'm happy we did it because we got that last out.
That was a great job by her to be able to tag that runner and then see that that runner was now going to second base. And heads up, too, by my center fielder, Tafaro, to come in and cover second base, and then to have my second baseman on first base to take the throw. So you practice a lot of that stuff, but I don't think I ever practiced that specifically. So they did a great job.
Freedom Division, so tough this year right now. Jefferson and Lenape tied for first, but Kittatinny's right there. Coach Bill Moore knows the season is far from over.
You know, we had a little falling out, but that happens with teams, you know. Like, we just have to get back in the groove, and I know we'll do it, so we're just going to come out on top, and it's going to go well.
It's a confidence booster, and, I mean, we just got to beat them again, and we got a game tomorrow in the league, so we're going to try to beat that first and see how it goes.
We're hoping to beat Jefferson again when we play them, and we've played Kittatinny twice, so we don't have that opportunity again, but definitely a good win for us.
That's what I was telling the girls. I was hoping that this would get us on a little bit of a roll. Like you said, it's a quality team. They were undefeated in the league, so it's a good win against a good team, and hopefully it gets us on a little bit of a roll.